Hello students, today I am going to discuss the part 2 of crop production and management, that is the chapter 1 of class 8th science. In part 1 I have already discussed up to the basic practices of crop production. Under this head I discussed two practices, that is your preparation of soil and sowing. And today in this part we'll discuss two more basic practices, that is adding manure and fertilizers and irrigation. Under adding manure and fertilizers we'll discuss about water manures, water fertilizers, why they are used in the field, what is the need and the difference between fertilizers and manures and advantages of using manures. Then we'll discuss irrigation, which is another basic practice of crop production. Under this irrigation we'll discuss why irrigation is required, what are the sources of irrigation. Then the main points are your traditional method of irrigation and modern method of irrigation. So let me start with the third basic practice of crop production, that is adding manure and fertilizers. Now why this step should be there? See, for healthy growth of plants, the substances which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients are called manure and fertilizers. But why to add the manures and fertilizers to the soil? See, when the farmers are not growing a single crop in a field for one time, so they are continuously growing different types of crops alternately. So by growing the crops continuously, gradually the soil becomes poorer in certain nutrients. As a result, what happens? For the next crop production, while producing the next crop, after continuous crop production, the soil is deficient in nutrients, so the plant will not grow properly and crop production will be less. Therefore, the farmers have to add manure or fertilizer to the field to replenish the soil with nutrients. And the process of adding the manure to the soil is called manuring. Now let me tell what is manure and what is fertilizer. Manure is an organic substance obtained from decomposition of plant waste or animal excreta. You know what is decomposition, who decomposes and what are decomposed, and what are organic substances. There are two types of chemical substances. One is organic substance, other is inorganic substance. The organic substance are generally obtained from the living organisms like plants and animals, animal body, whether it may be from their dead part or from the waste materials released from their body. And inorganic substances are the organic substances contain carbon and hydrogen in general, but the inorganic substances are containing the substances other than carbon and hydrogen. Carbon and hydrogen may be there, but along with that some other substances are there, but presence of carbon and hydrogen is not compulsory. Okay, so these organic substances present in the plant waste or animal excreta or animal waste are decomposed by the bacteria, the microorganism, and they are converted into the organic manure. Then how the farmers are preparing this manure? Are they moving here and there to collect the manure, or they are preparing the manure themselves? The farmers are preparing the manure themselves. They prepare a pit in an open place, and then they dump the plant and animal waste in the pit, and then they add some cow dung to that. The cow dung contains some bacteria, and that bacteria decomposes the animal and plant waste, and ultimately your manure is prepared. Now, what is fertilizer? As I have told you, that organic substances, the manures are organic substances, but the fertilizers are the inorganic salts. They are also chemicals. They are chemicals, inorganic salts, and they are not prepared naturally. The manures are prepared naturally. Automatically they are decomposed by the bacteria, so it is a natural process. But fertilizers are manufactured in factories, so it is an artificial method. It is prepared by artificial method, and they are very rich in nutrients, specific nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. And they are commonly known as NPK fertilizer. N is for nitrogen, P is for phosphorus, and K is for potassium. K is the symbol for potassium. So the fertilizers are generally rich in these three components, three chemicals. Now, why fertilizers and manures, and which should be preferred by the farmers? No doubt, fertilizer is easy to purchase from the market and directly apply in the soil, and it will provide huge amount of nutrient to the soil. But manure, it takes time to be prepared, and the farmer has to prepare this, and it will take more time to replenish the nutrient, soil nutrient. But why manure should be preferred? Why not fertilizers? So in order to know why the manures are preferred, manure should be preferred, we should know the differences between fertilizers and manures. As I have told you, fertilizers are inorganic salts, but the manures are natural and organic, as they are obtained from the animal and plant waste. Then fertilizers are prepared in the factories, and manures are naturally produced by the farmers in their field itself. Then, when fertilizers are added to the soil, it has many side effects, like it may kill the microorganism, friendly microorganism present in the soil, which helps in increasing the fertility of the soil. It may decrease the fertility of the soil or quality of the soil, texture of the soil. But manure, when we add to the soil, it does not harm any, that is, does not harm the soil. It has no harmful effect on the soil because it is completely naturally produced. Next, fertilizer is having one advantage. It provides many nutrients, and huge amount of nutrients are provided by the fertilizers at a time. whereas manure provides nutrients or the organic matters to the soil very slowly. And another difference is that the continuous use of fertilizer or excess use of fertilizer is not at all good for the soil. It decreases, as I have told you, it decreases the fertility and also quality of the soil, not only in terms of fertility but also in terms of texture. So when texture will be changed, then the water holding capacity of the soil will also be changed. Okay, but manure is quite good for long term use, and when it is used in excess, it increases the soil fertility and also it improves the texture of the soil. It makes the soil porous and it increases the water holding capacity of the soil. So these are the some of the differences between fertilizers and manures, and I hope by this time you may say that why manure should be preferred and which one is advantageous, manure or fertilizer. Obviously it is manure. So let us discuss the advantages of manure. As I have told you, it is rich in organic matter. So when it is added to the soil, it makes the soil porous and it increases the soil fertility in general. It provides some nutrient in small amounts, no doubt, but we have to in order to add more nutrients, we have to add more manure. But it has many other advantages. As it made from waste products, so environment is cleaned. Instead of throwing the waste here and there and polluting the environment, if this waste will be dumped in a pit and it will be converted into manure, then that manure will be used in the agricultural field to increase the crop production. So definitely it is eco-friendly way and it cleans the environment. It increases the water holding capacity of the soil because it makes the soil porous. It increases the friendly microorganism in soil because by adding manure the soil becomes porous. So the content of oxygen inside it increases, so the microorganism can grow easily. Which friendly microorganism means which are useful for the plant growth or which increase the fertility of the soil, and it also improves the texture of the soil. Texture means what? The particle, soil particle size, shape. These are the texture or the structure of the soil is changed, and the structure of the soil is related to the water holding capacity of the soil. Now that the next step is your irrigation. It is after your adding manure and fertilizer, the most important step is your irrigation. Irrigation means what? Watering the crop at regular interval. And why water, why irrigation is required? Water is important for proper growth and development of the plant, first thing. Water is essential because germination of seed does not take place under dry condition. For germination of the seed, we need water. Okay? And besides that, during growth of the plant, how the plant will absorb the nutrient from the soil if water will not be there? So if the soil contains water, then only the nutrients dissolve in water and then gets transported to each and every part of the plant after being absorbed by the root. Okay, the root will absorb the nutrient only when it is dissolved in the water. Then after absorption, the nutrient will be sent to different parts of the plant only when the nutrient is in dissolved condition. Besides that, water also protects the crop from both frost and hot air current. So frost means you know that when it is cold, there is chance of frost, and hot air current. In that case also, water, if water is there, then it can protect the crop. And how it protects the water, that we'll discuss in higher class. But still, let me tell, it keeps the plant rigid so that the plant will not break. Okay, there will be no harm to the plant. The supply of water to crop at different interval is called irrigation. But for irrigation, generally we use if I'll ask you, what is the source of irrigation for crop, from where we are getting water, then immediately somebody will say that the rain water is the main source. But it is not at all good to depend on rain for water, as it is not fully reliable. We are expecting, suppose say we are expecting rain in the month of July, but sufficient rain may not be there. So in that case, we should not rely on the rain. Therefore, a proper irrigation system should be there, so that regularly and timely we can provide sufficient amount of water to the crop. Okay, so if irrigation will be proper and sufficient, then definitely yield of crop will be more. Now, besides rain, as it is not reliable, so what should be the other sources of irrigation? So here are some sources of irrigation. There are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, canals, streams, etc. Now, what are the methods of irrigation? Here you can see some of the traditional method of irrigation. See, in the first case, the moat pulley system is there. In my childhood, I have seen this system, and even I have sometimes I play with this nearby my home. One farmer was there, his field was there, and there was a well. From the well, with the help of pulley, he was taking out the water, and then he was pouring it in the field. So I have seen this, and nowadays you people may not see this method, because farmers are, the technology is so advanced, and farmers also wants to save the time and also to save the water. So here there is a moat, means pulley system is there. With the help of a pulley, the water is drawn from the well, and then it is supplied to the field, or the field is irrigated. Then the other one is your chain pump. The second one is chain pump. So with the help of a chain pump, there is a pump system. Chain pump, the water is drawn from either from the well or from the nearby river or canal, and then it is supplied to the underground water is generally drawn out, and it is supplied to the field. The next, dhekli is there. Dhekli, I have also seen this in my childhood. Dhekli, a log is there, and at one end of the log there is a big stone or any heavy material is attest to that, and the person who will pull out the water from the well has to tie the bucket or any container to other end of that log, and then he will just pull out, put the bucket in the water, and after the bucket is being filled, automatically, because the other end of the log is heavier, so automatically the bucket with water will be pulled out, and then that water will be poured in the nearby field. The next method is your Rahat liver system. So in this liver system, the farmers are taking the help of a bull. So it is just like that is your when the bull here, there is a beam. That beam is placed on the neck of the bull, and when the bull will move around the central point or the reference point, the water will be, the underground water will be drawn, and then there is a wheel, and to that wheel many containers are attached, and that container will collect the water, pour the that is collect the water, pull out the water, and then it will pour in the nearby field. So these are the traditional method. But why nowadays we are not using the traditional method? There are so many disadvantages in the traditional method. But first thing is that it needs labor. It takes more time. Then most important thing is that in the present scenario we are facing the water scarcity, water crisis. But in the traditional method, there is a huge loss of water. So these are the disadvantages of traditional methods of irrigation. So that's why nowadays the modern methods of irrigation have been emerged out, and popularly these methods are used by the farmers. So there are two modern methods of irrigation. One is sprinkler system, other is drip system. And I hope all of you have seen this sprinkler system and drip system. In sprinkler system, the perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on the top are joined to the main pipeline. I will show you the diagram. At regular intervals, these pipelines are there, and when water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of a pump, it sprinkles from the rotating nozzles and it gets sprinkled on the crop as it is raining. Okay, so here let me show you the diagram of sprinkler system. Here you see the main pipe. There is a long main pipe where from the main pipe the side perpendicular pipes are there, small pipes are there, and those pipes are perpendicular to the main pipe, the long pipe, and the small pipes are having a nozzle at that tip, and when water is passed through the main pipe under pressure. So how the pressure will be created? By the motor, the pressure is created. So when the water passes through it, because the water is under high pressure, so the water is sprinkled. The water is sprinkled. And sometimes the nozzle is, rotating nozzle is attached, so that the water can be sprinkled in all the directions. And in this way, the water, the field gets irrigated. Then another method is your drip system. In this system, the water falls drop by drop just at the position of the root. So it is called drip system. Drip means what? Drop by drop. in sprinkler system it is sprinkled like a rain. So here you can see in the diagram the drip system. In the drip system you can see the crops are the plants are grown in lines, in a regular interval they are grown. In between them the pipes are there, the pipes are spreaded, and the pipes are having holes at regular interval, and when water passes through it, see the pipe is very close to the plants. So when water is allowed to pass through it, the water falls at the root of the plant drop by drop. So this drip system has a greater advantage. What is that advantage? Even the drip system is more advantageous than the sprinkler system, because in sprinkler system when we sprinkle the water, the areas where plants are not there, the water falls in those areas too. But in drip system the openings of the pipes are opened exactly at the root of the plants, so and the water is falling drop by drop, it is supplied to the plant drop by drop, so there is no water loss, the wastage of water is almost zero. But in sprinkler system also we are conserving the water, but as compared to drip system, in sprinkler system some amount of water is wasted. So in that way drip system is more appropriate or more preferred or more beneficial than the sprinkler system. So for today this much only. Thank you.